สวัสดีครับ good day once again this time I will speak a bit about the no confidence or censure debate on the Prayut's government from the 19th to the 22nd of July and the voting to approve or not to approve the government of General Prayut did take place on Saturday the 23rd of July just a few days ago and the result was in favor of the government. The no confidence vote did not pass the majority votes of the members of the House of Representatives. The motion to defeat the government of General Prayut was defeated. Okay, so the government side under the leadership of General Prayut won handsomely. Okay, but the reasons and the story behind the voting and so on is not something that to be desired, because there is a sort of politicking, some corrupted practices and so on of money politics into the game in order to convince certain members of parliament to vote in contravention to his or her or their political parties respective decision and so on. And there has been rumors about money being passed around in and around the parliament for some of the members of parliament to vote otherwise and so on. It's not a happy episode and so on. And I think all in all, the answers from the government side by 11 ministers led by the prime ministers were not too convincing. And somehow I think the answers were quite divorced from the reality of life of ordinary people, that in the midst of inflation, COVID-19, lack of planning and all of this and so on, and the reality of life and so on, that more or less reflected the mismanagement or the underperformance of the government led by General Prayut Chan Ocha. But I think the government, the prime ministers and his cabinet members, I think for the past few days most probably have been basking in the sun of the success inside the parliament on the question of the no censure or no confidence vote. But a few days ago, some democratic activities did take place in the Thai society outside the parliament. And as a sequence to the censure and the voting debate inside the parliament on the 23rd of July, as I mentioned, I think because four professors or lecturers from four universities, namely Thammasat University, Rangsit University, and Prasanmit University, and the graduate school NIDA, National Institute for Development and Administration, they got together and organized a voting platform to express their views on the performances of the government inside the parliament during the no confidence vote from the 19th to the 22nd of July. And citizens of Thailand to the number of 500,000 did participate in this online voting through the handphone and the iPad. And more than 96% of the 500,000 votes casted gave a negative answer to the government. That is, they went along the no confidence motion, that they were dismal and they were not in agreement with the performances of the government. So in that sense, the People's Forum defeated the government or went along with the no confidence vote. More than 90% out of 500,000 voters is something remarkable. And this is something that General Prayut Chan Ocha, the Prime Minister, has to stop basking in the sun because of the result of the voting in the parliament and take the people's concerns and their voices seriously. That he must, I think, from now on, from today, from this very moment, have some sort of self-inspection. What has gone wrong with his performance and his leadership in the government and so on? And what is he going to do with other 10 ministers who were, I think, debated at the no confidence motion? Their behavior, personal behavior, their official performance and so on, were they up to par? And he should do something about it. Should he reshuffle the cabinet and find a better ministers to perform the functions of running the government and so on? This is a serious thing because the votes of 500,000 or 500,000 people is not a small matter. The number is much larger than 471 members of parliament in the House of Representatives. It also reflected that the people were listening attentively to the debates inside the parliament from the 19th to the 22nd of July, that they are active and concerned citizens about the welfare of the country and the underperformance of the government under General Prayut Chan Ocha. That's one thing. General Prayut Chan Ocha cannot remain idle. He must take the decisions of the 500,000 voters into consideration from this very moment. That's the first point. The second one is that I think Thai public in general is quite familiar with using the handphone to vote. What they have been doing so far for several years is to vote to on the, I think, singing or song competitions and so on, you know, that have been organized by many of the television channels and so on. So they were, I think, quite well-versed with the voting by the handphone. But that is for entertainment purposes. But this time, the voting by the new technology of the handphone on political matters is an innovation in Thai political life. And it is also for the first time that direct democracy did take place in Thai political arena, that the people can vote on the politicians directly. It's an innovation, and I think it's a turning point that in the future, many of the public issues tabled by the government inside the parliament and so on could be voted by the people first before the final decision by members of parliament and so on. And in that sense, I think congratulations and accolade must be given to the four professors, lecturers, and to the universities for such a very innovative idea, and I think a means to increase public participation in the political affairs or life of the country and so on. It is to be welcomed, and hopefully that there will be more of this, and the four lecturers and the four universities, hopefully that they will be encouraged to do more for the enhancement of the participatory politics, for a better democratization process of the Kingdom of Thailand. Thank you very much. ขอขอบคุณครับ